terms the free cash flow to firm and free cash flow to equity. When we say firm, firm means total company, which have two stakeholders primarily, equity and debt. So equity and debt combined are known as firm. When we say firm or when we say company, that means we are talking about equity holders as well as debt holders. That is the total providers of capital or all the providers of capital to the firm or to the company. Now, free cash flow to firm means cash flow available for equity holders and cash flow available for debt holders. That means any cash that is available for equity and debt both, that is, that free cash is known as free cash flow to firm. So between free cash flow and free cash flow to firm, there is one key difference, and that difference is primarily of interest. Why? Because when we calculate net income, we have subtracted interest expense. So we arrive at our net income by subtracting the interest expense. When we say free cash flow to firm, it means free cash flow to equity holders and free cash flow to debt holders. ये जो interest की payment होती है, ये किसको pay होती है? Debt holders को pay होती है. So that means this interest payment is coming in from equity and going to debt holders. That means it is remaining within the firm. So if I am talking about the whole firm, that means if I am talking about equity and debt combined, interest payment is coming out of equity and going into debt. That means it is still remaining within the firm. So interest expense at firm level is not an outflow actually. So agar main debt holders or equity holders dono ko dekhu, so it is an outflow for equity, but it is an inflow for debt holders. That means at firm level, it is neither an inflow nor an outflow. So for you to calculate free cash flow to firm, to whole firm, you need to adjust for this interest. That means this interest should not be subtracted. लेकिन जब आपने नेट इनकम कैलकुलेट करी होती है, सो नेट इनकम के अंदर आपने इंटरेस्ट सब्ट्रैक्ट कर दिया होता है. सो दैट मींस नाउ फॉर यू टू कैलकुलेट फ्री कैश फ्लो टू फर्म, यू नीड टू ऐड बैक इंटरेस्ट, बिकॉज दिस इज नॉट एन आउटफ्लो फॉर द फर्म, दिस इज एन आउटफ्लो फॉर इक्विटी बट इनफ्लो फॉर डेट होल्डर. सो एक का आउटफ्लो है, एक का इनफ्लो है. नेट लेवल पे अगर दोनों को मैं कंबाइन करके देखूं तो ना किसी का आउटफ्लो है ना किसी का इनफ्लो है ऑन फर्म लेवल. So that's why for to calculate FCFF, we add interest. Now when you paid interest, you had some tax saving. So jo outflow tha, that wouldn't be equal to interest. Kyun? Kyunki aapka interest expense agar badhta hai, so aapka tax kam ho jayega. Because tax is applied on earnings after interest. So that means due to interest, there were some tax savings. So the actual cash flow tha interest se related, that wasn't equal to interest, but actual cash flow was interest into 1 minus tax rate. So interest expense for example aapka 100 tha, lekin is 100 ki wajah se aapko tax saving bhi hui thi. So you paid maybe $30 of less tax. So that means jo outflow tha, net outflow tha due to this interest was 70. 100 was your expense and tax saving due to this expense was $30. So tax 30 se kam ho gaya tha, interest 100 tha. So net tax, net outflow kitna hua? 100 minus 30, that is 70. So that means interest hone ki wajah se jo aapka outflow hota hai, wo kitna hota hai? Interest into 1 minus tax rate. Ya kisi bhi expense ke hone ki wajah se jo outflow hota hai, wo kitna hota hai? Expense into 1 minus tax rate. So now if I am adding back interest, I will add after tax interest and not the total interest. Kyunki kyun? Kyunki main sirf cash flow adjust kar raha hu. So I will only take the cash figure, not the interest expense figure, and that will be interest into 1 minus tax rate. So if you add interest into 1 minus tax rate to your free cash flow, that becomes your free cash flow to firm. So this is the free cash flow to the whole firm. By firm we mean equity as well as debt. These two combined make a firm. Or interest हमने add क्यों करा? Because it is coming out of equity and going into debt. So that means it is remaining within the boundaries of firm. It is not going out of the firm. So it should not be deducted. So this gives you free cash flow to firm. Now this can be further broken down. FCF can be further broken down into OCF minus capex, capex or cash flow from investments, whatever you use. And then OCF can be further broken down into net income plus non-cash charges माइनस वर्किंग कैपिटल इन्वेस्टमेंट. वर्किंग कैपिटल इन्वेस्टमेंट मींस माइनस इंक्रीज इन करंट एसेट्स प्लस इंक्रीज इन करंट लाइबिलिटीज. सो ओसीएफ कैन बी फर्दर ब्रोकन डाउन इनटू दिस इक्वेशन एंड देन वी कैन अराइव एट अ फाइनल इक्वेशन दैट नेट इनकम प्लस नॉन कैश चार्जेस माइनस वर्किंग कैपिटल इन्वेस्टमेंट माइनस कैपेक्स प्लस इंटरेस्ट इनटू वन माइनस टैक्स रेट गिव्स यू योर फ्री कैश फ्लो टू फर्म. रिमेंबर दिस इज फ्री कैश फ्लो टू फर्म एंड नॉट इक्विटी. सो एज वी डिस्कस व्हेन यू वैल्यू अ कंपनी यू विल फोरकास्ट फ्री कैश फ्लो टू फर्म. You will discount back all free cash flows to firm to present using a discount rate, and that discount rate will be weighted average cost of capital. Another key point to note is that FCFF is discounted at WACC. Why WACC? Because WACC will include equity cost as well as debt cost, and this FCFF is also the cash flow to equity as well as debt holder. So, जिसको कैश फ्लो होता है उसका कैश फ्लो उसी रेट पे डिस्काउंट करा जाता है उसी कॉस्ट पे. सो एज एफसीएफ पर्टेन टू एक्विटी एंड डेट बोथ दैट इज टू द होल फर्म देन डिस्काउंट रेट विल आल्सो बी द फर्म्स डिस्काउंट रेट दैट इज वैक वेटेड एवरेज कॉस्ट ऑफ कैपिटल एंड व्हेन यू डिस्काउंट इट बैक यू विल गेट प्रेजेंट वैल्यू ऑफ एफसीएफएफ फ्यूचर फ्री कैश फ्लो टू फर्म्स. And this present value of FCFS will tell you the value of firm. Again, what is firm? Firm is equity and debt. So if I have value of firm, how will I get value of equity? I can get value of equity by taking value of firm and subtracting the value of debt from it. So aapki jo firm hai, firm kya hoti hai? Equity plus debt. So if I only have to go for equity value, I will have to subtract value of debt from it. And when we subtract value of debt, we usually subtract value of net debt, that is debt plus cash. So this is how you arrive at the value of firm. Why FCFF, understanding FCFF is important is because without knowing FCFF or FCFE, you cannot perform the any kind of valuation. So you should know these cash measures as well, in addition to OCF, in addition to cash flow from investment, and in addition to CFF. So you should know FCF, you should know FCFF, and now FCFE.